Today, we are going to talk about a couple you may not know. If I say the name Paul, if you've been around church a little bit, you probably know Paul. Paul was named Saul. He wrote a majority of our New Testament, from Romans to 1st and 2nd Corinthians to all the epistles, Galatians, Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, to the letters to Timothy. And Paul himself is the guy that wrote a chunk of the New Testament. But there was a couple behind Paul that you may not know. You may have heard them referenced before. In fact, they're only mentioned 7 times in Scripture. They're never mentioned without each other, Aquila and Priscilla. In fact, they're an interesting couple because we know they shouldn't have even ended up where they were in this Corinth story that we're going to talk about. But Claudius was the emperor in AD 50, 52, and Claudius ran all the Jews out of the Roman Empire, and they ended up in this town called Corinth. We know that Corinth was a decadent town. It was large, but it was wild, and there was a lot going on in Corinth, and a guy named Paul ended up showing up there, and this couple, Priscilla and Aquila, totally changed Paul's life. It's interesting because we know what all Paul did for others, but it's never noted in Scripture that Paul did anything for Priscilla and Aquila, but it always talks about what they did for him. I want you to write out beside the word kindness, the word selfless. I think one of the attributes of somebody who is kind and shows kindness is that they are also selfless people. This couple, always mentioned together, always mentioned as a pair, never mentioned for a big speech they gave, but rather the life they lived. So what was it about Priscilla and Aquila that marked the life of Paul? So Acts 18, verses 1 through 26, we're going to just sort of break some pieces out of that today as we talk about kindness and what it meant to Paul and what it means when we show it in our lives. Here we go. What's the first thing that kindness does? Well, they show kindness by what they gave. You know, you cannot show kindness without mentioning the word giving. And you may go, well, Mike, are you talking about offering? Well, more than that, right? I want you to write up 3 words: time, talent, treasure. We give of our time, we give of the gifts we have, and we give of our treasure, right? So what's interesting about Priscilla and Aquila is they plied the same trade as Paul. So we know Paul the apostle, but Paul also notes all throughout his writings that he was also a tent maker. That is how he made a living. He would make leather and build tents and coverings was basically what it was during that time. Well, they were of the same trade. Whether Paul knew they were also believers, we don't know. Most scholars think before Paul met Priscilla and Aquila, they were already believers. Most people already think that. And it's interesting to note that Priscilla, 4 of the 7 times they're mentioned, is mentioned first, which is very unusual, meaning she probably was the more vocal one of the that's the home I grew up in, the more vocal one of the family, right? She was more of the talker in the family, but yet everything they did was behind the scenes, and they showed kindness by what they gave. Now, you got to think back during that time, the last thing you want to do is bring in another tent maker into your community where you're trying to sell goods as well. But when a person shows kindness, they don't think of themselves. Who do they think of? Well, they think of others. You cannot tell me someone's kind if giving is not associated with their kindness. Why? Because it's the ultimate example of selflessness. It's giving. They gave of their time. They spent time with Paul. They gave of their resources. They gave of their talents to help Paul in this area as he tried to make some money to live and sustain himself. But not only do we give ourselves, by showing kindness about what we give. Number two, they showed kindness by what they did. Look at what it says in Acts 18:18. After this, Paul stayed many days longer and then took leave of his brothers and sailed for Syria, and with him Priscilla and Aquila. I want you to write down, they traveled with Paul. And these travels weren't like, hey, I would like a book a ticket on Delta to head to Jamaica, all right? These were not the travels. We know that on many of Paul's travels, he was shipwrecked. We know he was beaten. We know that he was imprisoned. And this couple, most think a wealthy couple, said, you know what? God has sent Paul into our life for a reason bigger than just tent making. We're going to open up not only our home to him, but when Paul left, they said, hey, Paul, we feel like your journey has met our journey, and we'll travel with you. Yeah, I meet so many people, and they go, Mike, what difference can I make for the gospel? I don't preach. I don't really have any big skills. I don't sing or have a talent to run something here at the church. How can I make a difference for the kingdom? Kindness. See, we don't know a lot about Priscilla and Aquila apart from the life of Paul. But we know this. Paul could not have been who he was if they were not who they were. You think about the world that we live in. You want to change our world? Kindness. Kindness. You walk with Jesus, kindness should be a fruit in your life. If somebody comes up to you and said, oh, I'm kind, well, they're probably not. But when we see kindness, it stands out because we live in a selfish world, and kindness is selfless. It's one of the fruits that is selfless. Number three, they showed kindness by what they said. They showed kindness by what they said. It's not only what they gave, it's not only what they did, it's what they said. Your lips are always part of it. Their lips, hands, and heart were part of how they showed kindness. You take Priscilla and Aquila out, you may not have all the gospels you have. And most of us couldn't tell you two things about them. But they didn't care about them. What did they care about? They cared about Jesus, and they showed the fruit of kindness.